Hey guys, I am Pixel Dan, and this is a review of the Masters of the Universe Club Grayskull Modulok action figure from the folks over at Super 7. So we are now on our final six Club Grayskull action figures, which are all based on their looks from the Filmation He-Man and the Masters of the Universe and She-Ra Princess of Power cartoon series. So Modulok here is more based on the way he appeared in that cartoon series rather than the vintage toy. So let's go ahead and dive right in and take a look at him. And we're going to start things off by looking at the packaging. So as you noticed, these do still come with the slip covers there. They have this great Castle Grayskull design. So back's got the He-Man and the Masters of the Universe logo. Removing that slip cover reveals this beautiful window box that sort of looks like it's inside the jaw bridge of Castle Grayskull. It showcases Modulok and all of his accessories and swappable parts in there. There's a lot going on with Modulok, so you can see he really fills out that blister there. His heads are actually almost covered by the little teeth hanging down from Grayskull there, because there's just so much going on inside of that packaging. When we flip it around to the backside, we've got an image of Modulok as he appeared in the cartoon series, holding his little fake robotic head that he built, because that's the way it was in the cartoon. And down below that, we even have a brand new bio inspired by the events from the Filmation animated series. So why don't we go ahead and get Modulok pulled outside of this packaging and get a closer look at him. All right, we got Modulok all opened up and I've got one head on him here. That's how we're going to start things off. And if I bring in the tape measure, you can see that he's about 6.5 inches tall, but he's very unique because as you can see, he's got three legs and he kind of stands in a bit of a squat pose because of those three legs. I'm really excited about this figure and I've had a lot of fun photographing him already. So Modulok is one of those characters who came from the vintage toy line, was brought into both the He-Man and She-Ra cartoon series, and he's really one of the only one of those villains that comes from the original toy line who got his own, like, episode-specific storylines. He's more than just a henchman to either Skeletor or Hordak. Like, this guy had his own arcs, and he was brought in a lot, and he's just a really, really fun character. And to me, this is one of the best ways to do a Filmation-inspired action figure because this isn't just a character who had a different look in the cartoon, but he kind of had this whole different, like, personality and, like, this whole different way about him. When you're thinking about Modulok, you're probably thinking about the vintage action figure where the gimmick was that he came with all those pieces that you can mix and match parts to kind of build whatever you want. He didn't really have that ability in the cartoon, so as a result, this figure does not really have the interchangeable limbs, not in the traditional sense that you're thinking. So maybe that's a disappointment to you if you think that's what Modulok should be, but if we're talking about one that is specifically supposed to capture the feel of his cartoon counterpart, I think they did a really good job with this guy. So let's go over some of the details with him here. We're going to start things off with the awesome head sculpt here. Now, he does include two heads. We're going to look at that second head here in just a bit, but this is his primary head. He was only a one-headed character in the actual cartoon, and he's just got this great, almost vampiric look to him there with the pointy ears. He's got the sharp fangs. He's got these crazy eyes with, like, just the black slit there. He just looks very maniacal, and he's sort of like this mad scientist character, so it really, really works for him. The torso has just got this purple kind of harness sculpted onto the torso. You got the great kind of purple bands around his arms with the little spikes. He's got these very unique spiked hands, which is very cool. Green belt there. And then, of course, he's got those three legs. This is a good part to go ahead and talk about the articulation before we get into all the cool extras that this guy comes with. Since he's so unique, we got a little bit of extra to talk about here. So the head is on that standard ball joint like you would always expect. Can move up and down, left and right, kind of roll it all the way around there. You got those ball-like hinges at the shoulder, so the arms can go up, forwards, side to side. You got swivels at the bicep. You got nice tight joints at the elbow that have a bit of that ratchet. You've got swivels at the wrist. There's no hinges at these wrists, but he's got interchangeable hands, which you can just pop out a socket just like this. That's going to be for some of his included features I'll show you in just a bit. He does have the torso crunch. He's got the swivel at the waist, and that brings us to the legs. So his two legs in the front are pretty much what you would expect. You've got the ball joints there with the hinges at the thighs, so they can move forwards and backwards. They can swivel at that ball joint. You got tight ratchet-like joints at the knees. The ankles can move forwards and backwards. They don't really rock side to side. Love the fins here on the back too. But this back leg is a little bit different. You can see it's not ball jointed at the thigh. Instead, it's just a hinge joint, which means it can only move up and down. It actually cannot swivel side to side. It only moves up and down. But then the knee is ball jointed on the back, so that can actually swivel, move in, move out, and then you got the same ankle joint there. So you can get perfect, like, tripod-like stances with this guy as he appeared in the cartoon series. I think it's awesome. I think he looks really cool. I think it works out really well. All the articulation is really nice on this guy too, so I didn't have any issues there. So I mentioned that he's got interchangeable hands. If you want to, you can swap out his hands there just by doing that. Boom, you can easily clip in the new hand. So he's got these more open clawed hands, or he's got more kind of natural clawed hands there. You can mix and match those however you want to, swap them in and out. I think they're very cool. I love kind of these more open clawed hands. And these are also really great for his next accessory, which is that second head. So in the Filmation cartoon series, in the episode Happy Birthday Roboto, the whole idea here was that Modulok was building himself a second head, and he was going to kidnap Man-at-Arms and steal Man-at-Arms' brain, essentially, and put it inside this head so that he can have two heads and extra brain power, right? What an evil mad scientist plot. So this is like a lifeless head, and you can get him posed like holding onto that head, especially with these open hands, which is so perfect. So just like in the cartoon, you can have him carrying around this extra head. Now, if you want to, like we saw him in the packaging, we've got this extra neck piece. So you can actually swap off his head. It's on the standard ball joint, just like our old classics figures always had the interchangeable heads. We can take this extra neck piece, we can clip it on the ball joint, and then we can clip each of these heads onto the ball joints on top of the neck, and boom, you've got yourself a two-headed Modulok. Maybe he stole Man-at-Arms' brain after all, or maybe you want to display this Modulok to feel more like your vintage action figure. So you've got the ability to do that just like this. Of course, that head's on the same kind of ball joint, so if you've got a preference, you could always just do this as well, and you can display Modulok with this alternate head. So it's really cool. It does still give you some mixing and matching, even though this guy doesn't have full interchangeability with his legs and arms and torso like he does on that vintage figure. You still got some fun mixing and matching options you can do, or you can just recreate scenes straight out of the cartoon series, which is really fun. And we're not even done yet, because one of the things that he could do, he's very much like Hordak in that he was able to change his hands into different things. So you've got a giant sledgehammer. And if you want to, you can pop out one of his hands, and in its place, you can put this big red sledgehammer. It's kind of a bummer we didn't get two of those, because in the scene in the cartoon, he changed both of his hands into sledgehammers. That would have been pretty awesome, but still, it's a fun accessory that they included. We've also got this crazy electrode, is what it's called. So it's like this weird ray gun thing. So either hand, you can swap them out, and you can plug this in instead, and now you've got him with this crazy electrode ray gun instead. So he's got tons of mixing and matching parts. Even if it's not as many as the other Moduloks have come with, there's still quite a few options for display with this guy. All right, my friends, it's comparison time. So we got to do this. Let's stand him alongside the Masters of the Universe Classics version of Modulok, which, as you can see, quite a bit different. That thing was an insane beast. So many pieces, so many crazy details, and you can see just how different the Filmation version is to that version that is based on the classic toy. And let's bring in that vintage toy again so you can see them side by side and see just how different they are. I gotta be honest, guys, I absolutely love this one. I think this is probably my favorite figure out of this most recent batch of Club Grayskull action figures. I always talk about how one of the best things for me personally out of the Club Grayskull line is getting characters that were only in Filmation. But the other good way to use this line is to give us classic characters that were so different in the Filmation cartoon, and Modulok really fits that billing. You've got a lot going on here, and he's very different from that beast that just has swappable parts in the vintage toy line. I mean, this guy's got some really fun extra pieces here, but it's really cool also recreating that unique look that he actually had in the cartoon series. This is a really fun figure, absolutely one of my personal favorites. So this most recent batch of Club Grayskull action figures was sold exclusively through pre-order on Super 7's website. The original cost on these guys was $35, but at this point, you're only going to be able to find them on the aftermarket at places like Big Bad Toy Store, and the price at this point I think is around $50. So happy hunting, my friends. Hey guys, thank you so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, hit that like button, leave me a comment, and don't forget to subscribe. Until next time.